Good morning all. In today's lecture, we are going to study source transformation. So to understand the concept of source transformation, you have to remember four important cases related to source transformation. So let's begin with case number one. What is basically case number one? If the voltage source is in series with the resistance, what is case one? If the voltage source is in series with the resistance, then it can be converted into current source parallel with same resistor. What is basically case number one in case of source transformation? If the voltage source is in series with the resistance, then it can be converted into current source parallel with the same resistor. I hope you have understood case number one. To understand case number one, let's consider one example. So in this example, as you can observe, voltage value is given, resistor value is given. Am I right? As per the case number one, if the voltage source is in series with the resistance, then it can be converted into current source parallel with the same resistor. So how you are going to find out the current value? I is equal to V by R simply by using Ohm's law. So what is V over here? 15 volt. What is the value of R given? 5 ohm. So if you are going to substitute in this particular equation, you will get I is equal to 3 ampere. So here the I is equal to 3 ampere is the ammeter value, current value, which is parallel with the resistance 5 ohm. I hope you have understood case number 1. Again I'll repeat case number 1. If the voltage source is in series with the resistance, then it can be converted into what? Current source parallel with the same resistance. I hope you have understood case number one related to source transformation. Coming to the case number two, which is exactly converse of the case number one. What is basically that? If current source is parallel with the resistance, if current source is parallel with the resistor or resistance, it can be converted into a single voltage source is in series with the same resistor. You need to remember case number two. Okay, what is basically that? If the current source parallel with the resistor, or you can say that resistance, it can be get converted into what? A single voltage source series with the same resistor. To understand case number two, let's consider one example. So in this particular example, you can observe current is given and the resistor value is given, that is I is equal to 5 ampere and R is equal to 5 ohm. These two parallel combination can be converted into as per the case number two. What is case number two? If the current source is parallel with the resistance, then it can be converted into series combination between what? Voltage source and the resistance. So as from the Ohm's law, what you need to do? You need to calculate what is V. What is V? V is equal to I into R. Substitute the value of I and R in this equation. What you will get? V is equal to 25 volt. I hope you have understood how to convert parallel combination into series combination. I hope you have understood case number 1 and case number 2. What was case number 1 that we had studied just now? Case number 1 is what? If the voltage source is in series with the resistance, if the voltage source is in series with the resistance, then it can be converted into what? Current source parallel with the same resistance. Okay, I hope you have understood case number 1. What is case number 2? If the current source parallel with the what? If the current source parallel with the resistance, then it can be converted into series combination, that is voltage source is in series with same resistance. I hope you have understood case number 1 and case number 2. Similarly, coming to the case number 3, what is given? Now, if the two voltage sources are connected in series, what is case number 3? If the two voltage sources are connected in series, then it will get added or subtracted depending upon the polarities. What is case number 3? If the two voltage sources are connected in series, as you know that what is series circuit. So if the two voltage sources are connected in series, then it will get added or subtracted depending upon the polarities. How you are going to consider that? Please pay attention over here. As you can observe, there are two voltage sources, V1 and V2. As I told you, depending upon their polarities, you need to add them or you need to subtract them. Now, let's consider this is V1 and V2. Now, you need to check the polarities. The first polarity is what? Plus. Here, minus. This is plus. This is minus. Both the polarities are same or equal, we can say that. In that case, you have to add them. Okay? So, what would be the voltage you'll get? Voltage is equal to V1 plus V2. Okay? To understand case number 3, let's consider two examples. Okay? The first example is what? As you can observe, both the polarities are same. So, what would be your voltage ka value? Which is equal to V1 plus V2. But, if you observe in example 2, here this is plus to negative and here negative to positive. Am I right? It means that the polarities are different. So, how you are going to find out the voltage value? Depending upon the higher value of the voltage. So, simply you need to assign that particular direction as it is. So, this is negative and positive. Am I right? And then you need to subtract V1 from V2 because 15 volt is greater than 5 volt. So, voltage V2 is greater than voltage V1. So, after subtracting, you will get voltage is equal to 10 volt, which direction is what? Downward direction. I hope you have understood case number 1, case number 2 and case number 3. Coming to the last important case related to the source transformation, that is, if two current sources are connected in parallel, okay, so then it can be converted into what, or it can be get added or subtracted depending upon the direction of the current. In previous case, it was related to the polarities. In case number 4, it is related to the direction of the current. Depending upon the direction of the current, you have to add them or you need to subtract them. So, please pay attention over here to understand case number 4. As you can observe in this particular diagram, both the direction of the current are in upward direction or both are in same direction. Am I right? So, how you are going to club them? As I told you, if the direction of the current both are in same direction, then simply you have to add them. If they are not equal, you have to subtract them, but you need to assign the direction of the current, which direction you are going to consider, the greater one. Please pay attention over here. So, to understand case number 4, let's consider two examples. In first example, you can easily observe this direction and this direction. Both the direction of the current are in upward direction. So, it means that both are equal directions. So, you have to club them. So, what would be the current? The current is equal to I1 plus I2. Similarly, if you consider example number 2, you can easily observe I1 is in upward direction. The direction of the I1 current is upward. The direction of the I2 current is downward. As I told you, you have to consider the greater current value. So, which current direction you will consider? The downward direction. So, simply you need to plot downward direction ammeter, but then you need to subtract them. So, how you are going to find out the value of this I? Simply I2 minus I1, the answer is 5 ampere. I hope you have understood all the 4 cases related to source transformation. Again, I will repeat. Case number 1, what is basically case number 1? If the voltage source is in series with the resistance, then it can be converted into what? Current source parallel with the same resistor. I hope you have understood case number 1. What is case number 2? Which is exactly the converse of the case number 1, we can say that. If the current source parallel with the resistance, then it can be get converted into voltage source is in series with the same resistor. Am I right? What is case number 3? If the two voltage sources are connected in series, okay? If the two voltage sources are connected in series, then it will get added or subtracted depending upon the polarities. And the last important case number 4 is what? If the two current sources are connected in parallel, then it can be get added or subtracted depending upon the direction of the current. I hope you have understood all four cases in related to what? Source transformation. In next lecture, we'll solve few problem based on source transformation. Thank you. Thank you so much.